gathering materials. What could be more soul-draining and fun-killing? Manually dangerous is massive grind of a game. No doubt, if this game was a Karate Kid, the house Miyagi told him to wax on would be on fire or in fine-grained dust. Everyone's looking for a good way to quickly get this hurdle done. Well, after explaining how to get all the data you'd ever need, today I'll look at manufactured materials, probably the biggest bunch of crap that you'll ever need. First though, before you go anywhere, you will need a ship and some useful modules. It doesn't really matter what you fly, but it'll be more helpful if you have something a lot maneuverable than a brick. Let's say a clipper or a chieftain, stuff like that. Toss in some cargo space, well, that will be definitely necessary, and some collector limpets. No, and of course, don't forget the limpets themselves, those pesky little cockroaches of this universe. Next up, you'll need to learn a trick called Frontier Development's Approved Gameplay. It goes like this. You find a randomly spawning signal source, any signal source, it works with any of them. These things have timers on them to show how long till they disappear. Keep that in mind. Jump into it, collect all the materials and all the things that you need to do, maybe eject some dead slaves or whatever, I don't care. Then the trick comes. Quit the fucking game! Did I fucking stutter? Quit it! Okay, now load back into the game and take your ship into supercruise. And look at that, there's your signal source still active. Ta-da, that's the trick. You can endlessly farm any and all signal sources in the same place without moving much. Well, when I say endlessly, that is as long as the timer does not run out. So, if you have, let's say, a game on a hard drive or slow PC, your collection rate of these materials will be impacted some. Now that you know the Frontier-approved gameplay trick, you can go ahead and start farming those high-grade emissions. These particular signal sources spawn the highest-grade materials of different kinds, depending on what state the system is in. On the screen, you can see approximate spawning state requirements for each of the highest manufactured materials. Mind you that some have higher chance or priority for spawning, since systems have several qualities that affect these things. And boy oh boy, does RNG not want to play ball sometimes. And once you've collected enough of those grade 5 materials, just go trade them downwards, and that's pretty much all you need to know about how to farm materials in Elite Dangerous. It's disgusting, and y'all love it, but it's literally a symptom of a bigger, wider problem in Elite Dangerous. Yeah, but who the fuck cares anymore? Certainly developers don't. For now, that's about all there is. Still, in case you need some help, maybe join my Discord. Folks there are helpful. And maybe, hey, you want to help me out in turn for my work and whatnot else? Well, for that, there's a nice Patreon and merch store links down below. Otherwise, feel free to check out the video on how to farm all the material data stuff. But as for me, for now, I'll just enjoy combat logging out the game while to the sheer boredom and despair due to the obscene grind and lack of fun. Yay!